Hi, and welcome to Straight Up Tech. Let's learn together. Now, in this video, we are going to learn how we can use the new GUI system of Unity to create our own menus. Today, we will learn two types of basic menus. That is the normal menu from which you can start or exit the game, and also how you can show or hide your menu according to your preference. Now, on the screen you can see I have already created a project, and if you don't know how to create your basic projects yet, you can always view my videos on how to create your first game in Unity. I will link it above. Now in this window, what I'm going to do is I will rename my sample scene menu systems, and in this menu system I'm going to create UI and canvas. Now you must always remember that whatever UI you want to use, you will always have to do it in the canvas, because in Unity the canvas is the parent element on which you can do your UI work. Now I'll click on 2D, and as I zoom out, you can see the whole canvas is displayed on the screen. I'll name this canvas as menu canvas. On the menu canvas, I'm going to create a child object, a panel. Now on this panel, I'll create my background images, my buttons and everything. So I'll name it menu panel. Now I want my panel to be a bit attractive, so what I have done is I have already downloaded an image which I can use. So to import a background image, what I have done is I have imported a image from the web. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a material. Create this material and name it as background image. Now in this I'm going to change the shader from standard to legacy shader and diffuse, and then select the image which I want to use as my background image for my menu systems. After using this, I'm going to go to my menu panel and select the source image as none, and then drag and drop my material to my materials component. See, now I have my background image set as my background image. In the menu panel, I am going to create another panel because I want to make changes to that panel, and I do not want to make any changes to this parent panel. So I'll go and create UI panel and name it as main menu. Now I'm going to make this the child of this, and to give a dramatic effect, I'm going to change the color to a bit of red and make it more transparent. That's it. Now in this panel, I'm going to create some text objects and some button objects. So create UI text, child of this text. Now if you're seeing this, now every object in the UI panel has this rect transform. Now rect transform is basically, the meaning is rectangle transform. Now everything is stored or can be written inside a rectangle in the UI system inside Unity. So I have this position system in Unity. So if I want to use it, I will do it Alt, select the position system, press Alt and Shift, and I'll move my text to the above of this screen. Now you can see that our transform center is set to this line. I'll move it a bit downwards this. The center will always remain here as we have set it to the above of the screen, and make the width something like 300 and height of 50, and you can write anything here. I'm going to write straight up tech. I'll change my font size to 40 and color to white. See, you can write the name of your game or anything you want. I've told you before, you can also change the font of your UI system. So they don't have the font installed by default like in Microsoft Excel or something like that. Whenever you want to use font, you will have to import them as assets. Now, I have some font stored in my system. I'm going to use that. So I have this Roboto font, so I'm going to import it by dragging and dropping to my assets folder. And in my text, I can change my font from Arial to anything I want. I'm going to use Roboto Lite. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some buttons to this UI. So same main menu, create UI button, and make it a child of main menu. I'm going to set this button to here, then I'm going to name it as the start button. Now for the second button, I'm going to create UI button and I'll place it here. You can arrange accordingly and name this button as quit. Now I'm going to change the text of these buttons. So I'll name this as start, obviously, and change the font to Roboto Lite. And I'll change the text of this to quit, so you can quit the game. Name this as quit also. Now this is the very basic set for UI menu system in Unity. Through this you can easily start and quit your game. So we'll write a script of how you can do that. Now since it is attached to a menu panel, I'm going to do add component and write a button working script, click add and open. Now we have our script open. Now in this script, as you can see, we won't be needing this line of code, so I'll remove it. Now since we are working in UI, so you will have to import the namespace UI, so using Unity Engine dot UI, and we are also using the scene management to change the scene according to the button press. So we are going to be using Unity Engine dot scene management. So in this we will create functions for various buttons which we will be using in the Unity UI. So first, as we are using the start button, so we will create a function void start button, and we will write the code whatever your button needs to do. Right now, since it's the button for starting our game, so you simply write scene manager dot load scene, scene manager dot get active scene dot build index plus one. So basically what this code is doing, this will just load the second scene in your built index folder. I'll let you know what this will do later on. Then I have the quit button, so simply void quit button. And what I want to do is, whenever I press this, I want to do application dot quit. Now since we will be testing this button in our basic environment, I will just write debug dot log application quit. Because the application.quit will not work in this environment, but it will work anywhere, like in your computer or in your mobile phone, etc. You'll save a script, and once we go back, we can easily assign those functions to our buttons by pressing the start. Then this component onClick will do the rest. Now what this onClick is, what to do when you click the button. So here I'm going to write add this function. So since our script is attached with the menu panel, so I'll do drag and drop this menu panel to runtime, and then you can see the button working script and all the functions that we have designed. So we want to start the game, so we will invoke, I'm not seeing this. Oh, now we have to make our functions public. So public now once we are back, we'll be able to see our function. See, the quit button function and the start button function. Now since this is the start button, so we are going to use the start button function, save it, and in the quit one you're going to add this, drag and drop the menu panel here, and same button working script and quit button, save it. Now we will just create a new screen for the sake of checking our buttons. We will name this screen, save the scene as main game. Now whatever game you have, you can make the scene accordingly. In this I'm going to create UI canvas, I'm going to basically repeat the steps what I have done in game. Go back script. Make a public function, go back, we need to using unity engine dot scene management. I'm simply gonna write here scene manager dot load scene, scene manager dot get active scene dot build index minus one. So basically we're just going to go back one scene, save it again, assign this button the same way, go back, add, drag and drop this function, go back screen and public void. And in the go back, I'm going to use the go back scene function, save it. So now I just have to put my two scenes in my build index. So to do that, file, build settings, and I will just add my these two scenes in a build index, and I want this to be displayed first, save it. After that, I'll go back to my menu systems. Now let's check what we have created. To 3D again, menu system, screen camera. Now when you press play, you will see this is what we have created. Now when I press start, this is how you will start your game. And when I press go back, here you are again back to your screen. Now if I press quit, nothing will happen. But you can see that in this left hand corner, application quit is being written because console is displaying that. This is how you can create a basic menu in your Unity UI. In the next video, I'm going to make you understand how you can hide or show your menu according to your choices. Thank you for watching. This is Straight Up Tech. Please do subscribe and click on the bell icon so you never miss a video from us again.